In this video, we're going to address a very serious topic of why you cannot learn cloud architecture or any type of architecture by doing a lot of hands-on labs. Hi, my name is Michael Gibbs. I'm the founder and CEO of Go Cloud Careers, and I've been an IT architect now for over 25 years. A network architect, an enterprise architect, a cloud architect, a business architect, you name it. I've had all the architecture roles. I loved them. And I've spent 20 years helping people just like you get your first tech job or get promoted in tech. And one of the things that really saddens me is I see so many people that want to become cloud architects. And they do cloud project after cloud project after cloud project. And they go on a cloud architect interview or a solutions architect interview, and they get asked architecture questions and they can't answer any of them. And they feel bad and they go and they do more and more cloud projects, and in the end, they get very good at cloud administration, which has absolutely nothing to do with cloud architecture. And when you want to be an architect, you need to have very strong technical skills. But you can't gain these technical skills by building. There's a difference between the knowledge that's needed to know how to design the system versus the knowledge which is on how to build the system. And I'm going to give you examples to make it very clear for you. But for the architect, like the cloud architect, we need to understand how the technology works, that underlying technology, and how to put it together in a manner that will optimize our clients' business performance while meeting all of their technical requirements. For the engineer or those that build, it's about the steps to build. So we're gonna go through what's called the thought experiment, and I'm gonna tell you what an engineer would do to build a small local area network versus what the network architect would need to do to put it into context. We could do this cloud architecture, AI architecture, any architecture in general, but there's so many things to consider in the network that I thought I would choose it. So let's say I taught you how to set up an Apache web server and plug it into a 3-router network. And here's what I did. I taught you how to install Linux on a server. Let's say it's a bare metal server. I then taught you how to set up the Apache web server. I taught you how to configure the Apache web server, meaning the commands to configure. I taught you how to manually hard code an IP address, default gateway, and DNS servers on the Linux machine. Now I then took 3 routers. I taught you how to configure those routers, configure the ports on the routers, the VLANs on the switch routers, the routing protocols on the router. So I taught you a lot of commands on how to do it. Things like config T, interface gigabit ethernet 0/0, the IP address command, and the no shut, and maybe a router OSPF1 for an example, network 10.0.0.0, 0.0.0.255, area 0. So I gave you some commands to put them into context. And I only mentioned those commands to put it in so you could see it. Now, you now know how to plug in that server and how to configure those switches and routers. Good news, you know how to do it. But here's what I need to think about from the architect perspective. I don't have to think about those commands as an architect because, quite frankly, it's not part of my job. But here's what I do need to think about. On that server that we're going to use for the web server, I need to think about what I need to get out of that server, meaning how much performance. So I now need to think about the type of CPU I use and the way that CPU is going to be used, and whether it needs more cache versus less cache in the CPU, whether it needs a higher frequency CPU, or whether it's more multi-threaded where it needs more cores and it doesn't need as much frequency for that application to perform the way it needs. I now then need to consider the application and think about the amount of DRAM that's going to be necessary to run that server so that we don't run low on RAM and have to use the swap file on the server to mitigate that with virtual RAM. Then I need to think about the type of storage I want to put in that server. Do I want to put a magnetic hard drive? Do I want to put an SSD drive? Do I want to put an NVMe drive in there? Do I want that server to have NVMe drives in RAID 0, RAID 1, RAID 5, RAID 4, RAID 10, what have you? Or do I want to use block storage over the network based upon scalability versus performance? Now, on that same server, I need to think about the type of network connections. Am I going to connect to 1 switch versus 2 switch? Do I want to connect to these switches in our bridge versus a routed type of configuration on them? And then I need to think about what speed do I need? Do I need 1 gig, 10 gig, 100 gig? Do I need to multiple links together? So I need to think about that just on the server. Now on the switches, before we can think about anything, we need to think about an IP addressing plan. Then we need to choose a routing protocol for the switches. Do we use a link state versus a distance vector protocol? And what do we gain by using a link state versus what do we lose by using a link state versus what do we gain with a distance vector protocol or a hybrid protocol such as EIGRP? Then we need to think about how fast the systems need to heal. So do the timers on any of these protocols then need to be adjusted? Now the connections to the switches, how big are they? Meaning in terms of speed, how far apart are they? Should we use a copper connection between these switches? Or is it long enough distance that we need to use single mode fiber? Or is it a medium enough distance that we could use multi-mode fiber? Now you're getting the point that what I need to think about as the architect versus the commands on how to build are completely different. So don't try to learn architecture by doing a bunch of hands-on labs. You will fail. I have taken tremendous numbers of cloud engineers and people that have done hundreds, if not thousands, of labs and retrained them to be architects, and they get hired. But the key is we taught them how to design. So what I want you to know this in your architecture career, it's not how to build. It's how to design. How to design is about that underlying technology and how that technology interplays with each other, and designing the technology in a means that meets the business needs, the performance requirements, the availability requirements in a manner that's going to optimize the business performance. So now you know why you can't learn architecture by doing hands-on labs. You need to train architecture, which is system design. From a technology perspective, the architect still needs many more business things to study as well. But from a technology perspective, now you know the difference. If you'd like to get your first cloud architect job or enterprise architect job or AI architect job, we've got a tremendous number of free resources to help you. Both videos on this channel, free ebooks in the description of this video, free webinars on Zoom, which you can join and you can ask us questions and we can talk about your career and how to become an architect, and they're all free. They're in the description of this video. Please sign up. I can't wait to see you there. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your architecture career, whether it be a cloud architect career, a solution architect career, an enterprise architect career, or an AI architect career. We love architecture careers around here. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you in another video very soon. Take care.